Hello everyone and welcome to the Money Man. Now we've just come to the conclusion of the World Cup in Russia. And first of all, big congratulations to the French. You guys played a great game against Croatia and deservedly won. And congratulations to England as well for actually going quite far in the tournament. A little bit disappointing at the end, but still, the lads did us proud. So, what am I going to talk about today? Well, you've probably guessed from the title of the video, from what I'm talking about and what you can see in front of you, we're going to talk about the Russian 100 ruble commemorative World Cup note. And as you can see, I've got a few of them. So let's dive straight into it. But before we do, I just want to say that Russia, you know, for all its faults, it gets a lot of bad press. But let's throw the politics out the window. I think they've done a great job in hosting this World Cup, and they should be congratulated for that. They did an amazing job. So let's get right into it. So here is the 100 ruble note, and it's very nice. It's very fancy. There's lots of bright colours in it. And what we have on the front is we have the legendary Soviet goalkeeper, Lev Yashin. He's sort of like lauded as Russia's greatest goalkeeper, and here you can see him on the front there, and you've got a sort of like a little Russian boy looking up to him as a sort of footballing hero, which is really really nice. I really like that sort of nod to one of Russia's great footballers there. And if we swing it around and look at the back, you can see on the back that we actually have a football with a geographical representation of Russia on the back. And then you've got the three layers of fans, which also make the three colours of the Russian flag. And I believe these might be all the names of the cities that will be hosting the different football matches. But I don't read Russian, so apologies if that is wrong. That's just a guess. But yeah, really, really nice note. Quite unusual, actually. Again, I've said this before about other notes. If you'd explained the colour scheme to me, I would have said no. Disgusting. I don't like it. It sounds awful. But actually, upon seeing it, it's not actually that bad. There are lots of security features, little tricks with UV light, where you can see like the official logo of the Russian World Cup in the front. And this football sort of lights up. I mean, you can actually already see the sort of reflective quality of it there. And there are a few other little security features in it that I can't really show because I don't have the right lighting in here. But yeah, pretty nice note. Now, the 100 ruble has become a bit of a theme with Russia recently in terms of commemorative notes, because it's been an eventful, you know, decade for Russia, and I'll show you why. So we've got the latest one, which is the World Cup 100 ruble, and then if we go back, like I said before, we had the Sochi Winter Olympics, which was, you know, overwhelmingly successful as well. Yeah, and with the stadium on the back. And then a little bit more controversial, we've got the annexation of the Crimea, when the Russians swooped in and sort of peeled it off from Ukraine and annexed it back into Russia. So this seems to be a thing with Russia at the moment. Their banknotes, their 100 ruble, seems to be subject of, redesign to commemorate some of the more notable things that have happened in Russian society recently. And obviously all these things have very global consequences. So I thought that was quite an interesting thing. So if you have all three, you've got a nice little Russian ruble commemorative mini set. So that's what I have for you today. These were quite expensive when they first started finding their way into the collector community. Now, for me personally, when I first saw them, I wanted to get hold of a few, and they were going at 100 Hong Kong dollars each, around about 10 British pounds. And I thought, no, that's crazy expensive, way above face value, way, way, way above face value. And I waited and I waited, and it was probably about 3 weeks after release. We had a money convention here in Hong Kong, and I actually bought these from a Russian gentleman and only paid $40 each. 40 Hong Kong dollars, that is. So I got mine for a really, really good price. So it's always worth waiting, guys. Don't always be in a rush to get hold of new notes that come out. You've always got to be aware of how many have been printed, okay? They printed 20 million units of these, so there are a lot. So the price is inevitably going to keep going down and down as, you know, the numbers of notes sort of like bleed into the collector community. So whenever anything comes out that is quite hot, just slow down and wait a little bit. You don't even have to wait long, maybe 2 or 3 weeks, a month, and the price will drop dramatically. So if you are doing this on a budget and you see something that you like and it's new, make sure you find out how many have been issued. Look at the face value. Look online, see how many people are purchasing it, what kind of price they are purchasing it for, and just wait and be patient, because you'll never know what kind of opportunity arises. For me, I'm kicking myself because I had an opportunity to buy 100 of these notes, a bundle, and they were going up $40 a piece, 40 Hong Kong dollars. And at the time, I had my eye on something else, so I purchased something else. I wish I'd been able to go back and actually get a bundle of these, because it's quite easy to make a little bit of money on them. But yeah, that's my video for today. If you want to have a really nice up close look at this note, go down to the link in the description and you can find this note on my Facebook page. Thank you so much for watching. I hope to see you guys again in the next video. Bye bye.